Thank you. that wonderful time of the year when we sing, "Come, thou long-expected Jesus," even though we know he has already come. And "Joy to the world," even though we know the world is not yet completely joyful. But that first Christmas was the advent of our hope that such a time will, one day, come. And we celebrate that hope. In the December 1925 issue of the Atlantic Monthly, Joseph Newton began a Christmas article by saying, "Only God could have thought of Christmas." I thought he was right. Can you imagine how we would have planned it? Had we been God looking down on the world we have made, seeing its people, our highest creation, living so pointlessly, wandering in hopelessness, warring with each other, squandering the gift of life, how would we have presented our world with a message of hope and peace? I think it's safe to say that our plan would not have included a young girl in Nazareth making plans to marry a carpenter. And I'm pretty sure it would not have occurred to us to make our announcement in a little town nobody ever heard of in the hills of Judea. In our plan, I don't think there would have been shepherds watching their flocks by night. I think there would have been no stable, no manger. In fact, I'm pretty sure that our version would not have included a baby at all. No, only God could have thought of Christmas. Thank you.
Break forth, O beauteous heavenly light. That was the poet's way of describing the miracle of God's Christmas. The power of darkness breaking, our peace eternal making. And so it was, the Bible says, that in the fullness of time, in God's plan, a child was born and his mother called him Jesus. What an astounding way for God to give us hope and peace.
stable walls and manger bed, lowly beasts around him. Long the world its Savior sought, and this is where they found him. No, that would not have been our plan, but it was God's plan. And there in the manger lies our hope, our peace, our joy.
Oh.
In the words of Isaiah, I remind you, for unto you a child is born, unto you a son is given, and his name is called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace.